Good evening.
Good evening.
Carol, how are you?
I'm fine, thank you. So the budget, as you've recognized, begins on page 23 and goes to page 25. And the first page...
Before we start, I'm going to ask for a motion.
Do you want me to move the total? Is the total on 125?
Yes.
25.
Okay. Move 186,364.
Thank you.
Second.
Okay. The budget actually has two pages. The first budget is more of the in-house side of it, page 23. And then there's the, other than litigation expenses, the page 25 is the outside portion with the total. And the total of 186,364, as recommended by the town manager and by the selectmen, is 21.87% down from the last year's budgeted figure. And I'm happy to answer any questions.
We submitted questions, Mark.
I've not gotten them.
Christy, what's that?
The questions I got from you were only for me, and you said that in the email. There was like three pages, but there was none for Mark on there.
No, just, the questions were prepared for last week's meeting. And
is that the one that begins with pay of planning?
Yeah, that's my fault. So
you want to start with your?
Why don't you start with the questions?
Okay.
And then we'll go around.
No, it's not. I don't either.
Okay. I've got a couple of questions, Mark.
Sure, of course.
The total cost of this town attorney's office, if you will, is down $42,530 from the last 3 years' actual averages. And this year's budgeted number, when taken as a whole, average over 4 years. This is about the one employee that we lost. I see that $10,000 has already been added under other labor costs, projected services, which seems high given 12, 13, and 14 to date. But this will not cover the shortfall. I don't know how you can do it, Mark. I think that's the elephant in the room. How are you going to be able to maintain your office down? One half of your department is down. And we got Wanda at a tremendous discount.
Yes.
And I have strong feelings about this. I've been close to the office for 3 years. I know what you go through with zoning and plans and what you find and boundaries and easements that were never discussed. I know you're in Concord a lot with tax abatement issues and coordinating key witnesses to stand up with you for that, where the assessments are high and the tax abatement is argued to be high, if you will. And all the other things associated with your office, the legal pursuits that the town gets into with civil suits and so on. I just can't see you pulling this off. I'd like to have your comments.
Sure. It's important to remember that Wanda had a dual role of assistant town attorney and human resources coordinator. And there has been, as you mentioned, some additions personnel-wise, monetarily, to take up part of what would be a second person's role. Mm-hmm. One of the additions is $5,000 additional dollars to the selectman's administrative assistant, with whom I work quite closely in reviewing invitations to bid and contracts. She's quite skilled in that, and ultimately, my review of what she does will, she'll be doing a lot of the work that Wanda was doing in that regard. Staff-wise, for secretarial services, the selectmen have very kindly, during the year, hired someone for me, exceeded to that hiring. someone at 16 hours a week, $16 an hour on a part-time basis, and there is built into this budget an increase to 20 hours. That's someone who will answer the phones for me, do the clerical work that I was doing, because Wanda and I were each doing our own clerical work. So that's a big help there. With regard to the human resources coordinator, it's important to remember that while Wanda was an attorney doing that, that was in-house capacity in that very important field. And that in-house capacity is now shifted to another individual with a different title, but who also is quite skilled in that area. I've observed, Jamie, in the doing labor work in a number of ways and seen how very skilled he is at saving the town money in this regard, handling of grievances from the ground level. And I think that he will do a tremendous job in taking care of that part of what Wanda did. Now, in terms of the civil work that is the bulk of what I do, as you mentioned, the tax abatement cases, there are some cases that I was having Wanda handle, especially zoning enforcement cases, that are pretty much concluded at this point. And so I think as the need arises in specialty areas, there is an amount built into the budget that anticipates my use of outside counsel if necessary. I have not exceeded that amount in the past and don't expect to, but it is a contingency that the selectmen have allowed me to build in that I think I can draw upon in such specialty areas as environmental law, bankruptcy, that even we're a little beyond Wanda's skill level. So I think when you couple all of those factors together, I think we'll be well served.
Yeah, I have comments on those, inputs you just give. Your administrative aide is strictly administrative. There's no paralegal to that position.
Well, she's an experienced clerical person. From a number of years, and I think when I call upon her to take examples of what we've done before and apply them to what we have, she can do some drafting, that's for
Does
sure.
Does Christine have any paralegal background?
Christine?
Secretary or legal background or paralegal background?
Well, for years she's worked with me on the invitations to bid, on drafting them and what's needed in those documents. And in terms of contracts, has seen those also. So I'm not dealing on a blank slate with that by any means.
And the HR coordinator, as I recall, when I left my position, that was only requiring about 20 hours a month for HR work.
Well, the thing about that is the importance of having someone with Jamie's background and the ability to focus on that area. Wanda was doing two things at once. She was doing, of course, the assistant town attorney working on cases and the human resources on the other side. I think if you have someone, and the new title is human resources director, who can focus on that and spend more time on that, I think that's a big plus for the town.
One more question, Mark. What was the salary of the position that you just lost, this year's salary?
Well, that had been proposed to be raised.
About this year's 2014 salary.
That was at the rate of about $50,000, is my understanding, 49 to 50. And the proposal was to raise that up to 59.
I'm through asking questions.
We'll go back to Jim.
Okay. Mark, in working with the town manager and changing these positions and stuff, I think you worked pretty closely with him on making the recommendations and stuff, and I think having an attorney, an assistant attorney doing clerical work was a waste of your time, right? You're paying money for that. I think having a new clerical position is better.
Absolutely.
And I think it was just decided that this would be a good move and a move that would benefit the town in general.
Yes, so. That person, as I've said to you before, is someone who can pitch in with other departments and has, as needed,
help on specifics. So although it is certainly someone who works with me every day, she's available to other departments as well.
So would you say that sort of in a general way that it was a look at the department and the needs of the department and sort of an efficiency move and to make some changes?
Definitely.
Okay, that's all I have.
My question is, in the 2014 budget, we didn't have part-time wages. It's in the 2015, and it's also in the default budget. How did that, so where did that money come from for this year, for part-time secretary?
Well, the selectmen have the ability by state law to organize departments as they see fit. And the monies to do that come from the overall budget. They can, within a year, as they have, hire personnel to staff departments as they think are the most efficient and best to do. And they have the ability to hire the assistant town manager. They have the ability to hire the clerical personnel needed in various departments and made that decision as they saw the need.
Yeah, I have three questions. You said that Wanda made around $50,000.
That was without benefits.
What were the benefits?
I'm not sure exactly what the benefits were. Christy would have to answer that one for me, but I believe it was...
probably 35 to 40K.
What?
I guess it would be 35 to 40K.
Did she have a family plan, or did she have...
Yes, she was on a family plan, yes. Her medical alone was $23,378.
Okay, and what
for the town's portion of it?
Okay, and what was the was she in the retirement plan?
Yes.
And how much did we contribute for that?
It was a sheet that was sent around to everybody on with all of those, and Christy's told us for now.
Send out to her twin.
To the board.
Yeah. I have a number of copies if you need one.
Oh, I don't have one of those.
Yeah,
oh,
here you go. You have one of those.
The
retirement, Mike, is $6,526.
$6,526.
It should be on the sheet that's coming your way, but that is the retirement breakdown there.
Okay.
We got an email.
So that adds up to about $79,000.
Then there's Social Security, Workers' Comp, Medicare, life insurance. Did it make it around yet to you, the number?
Oh, yeah. Okay.
It's all there.
Steve,
do you need one?
So, but that $59,000 was not in effect until the proposed budget for 15, right? Is that a correct statement?
That's what he said.
I'm looking at the sheet that just passed around. She was only making $50,000, from what I understand, rather than $59,000. So the sheet's erroneous to start with, is what I'm trying to say. Am I correct on that? When she was last employed, what was she making?
You are correct. When she was last employed, that number was not the number.
That's correct. So this number here is incorrect.
That's the number we were working on. That's the number that was proposed for her salary, yes. But it is not the number that when she passed away, she's earning. That's correct.
So what this does is that reduces this $94,000 down to $87,000.
That's correct.
Okay, so now we are in the hole even more on this transfer of positions and money then.
Based on your logic, yes, that's correct.
No, I mean, I don't, not my logic, sir. I mean, I'm saying that's factual, what she made last year, isn't it?
Yes.
Okay, and it's
what
factual.
She was making when she passed away, that's
And it's
correct.
Factual, then she'd be around $50,000 for a salary, and that would reduce this number to about $83,000 or $85,000, somewhere in that range, correct?
That's correct. I'm sure you're doing that.
Thank you. So I'm just saying that we are... But this document's not correct. So I think we need to regroup on this a little bit. And I think what we need to have, if we could ask Chris to do it, is have a document that is correct so that the taxpayers and the budget committee will have more to work with, more accurate information. Okay, the next thing I have for you, Mark, is this one.
Sure.
Mike, can I just interject? Chrissy, if you could prepare that on the actuals and send it to Joan, and Joan, if you could just attach that to the minutes, then everybody will get it at the same time.
Thank you. Thank you, Madam Chairman. I have, when Wanda was here, God rest her soul, I liked her very much, and I appreciate her work immensely, but putting that aside, if we can, she put in about 20 hours per month.
I'd have to go back and look at that. That was what she, I had asked her to keep a rough log of that. That may be about right. That's what was, when it was first budgeted by the selectmen, the thought was that she would spend about 3.6 hours, I think, a week. And I think she was actually doing more than that. It was to off, the thinking on that regard was to offset the making of her into, as full-time as against what would be paid to outside counsel.
Well, I know that we did do some changing from part-time to full-time and things like that, as we call. And my memory serves me that she did work about that much time per month. That's the way I recall that, too. So that's, I have a problem with that.
I think that increased somewhat since you're talking because she was a member of the negotiating team.
Okay. Well, assuming that she even worked a few more hours, that still leaves a bundle of hours left that she worked on other legal activities. And the problem I have with that is if she spent the balance of almost that, the rest of it, almost the balance of that, working on legal activities rather than HR, that means to me that you're going to be a really busy person.
Depending on what happens with the various things that go on, I that's always been true.
So my problem with that is I don't think that looking at this all by itself, that what we're doing here possibly is imposing upon you an almost impossible task. That's the way I read that. Doing almost twice as much work, assuming that she worked almost as many hours as you did per week, that to me seems like almost impossible task to ask somebody to do. I know you're not looking for sympathy, but if I was in your position, I would tell somebody to reconsider.
When the position was created by the board, I had given them a memo about what our current status was, mm-hmm. including a list of cases, mm-hmm. so that the board knew what our caseload consisted of. And we also have the situation where, thankfully, we now have a town planner in place. For the 6 months before our new planner was hired, mm-hmm. the manager and I were essentially splitting the role in various ways. That I thankfully don't have to do. If that were still in place, I would probably agree with you that I've got a big headache. But I don't now, thankfully. I think the new planner is someone who's doing a great job and is very knowledgeable. And I think that the cases that Wanda was handling and tried recently, as I said, have come to an end so that I won't have to be focusing on those areas. And I do have the cushion of outside counsel money still that can be used for specialty areas like bankruptcy that she was handling.
But my impression, if I remember correctly, watching the planning board and zoning board meetings and so forth, there was quite a bit of your involvement disregarding the fact it was the planner. Like, for example, when we were looking at one particular case involving the height, you were involved with that a lot, as I recall, because we, as selectmen, had to make a decision on that, and we relied on your expertise to guide us through that prompt. You spent probably a better chunk of a week's time, just that item alone, if nothing else.
Actually, there was a case involved there, and that was outside counsel, believe it or not.
There was a, when we were involved with the one where we had the selectmen had to make a decision on it.
Yes, that was outside counsel.
But you had to guide the outside counsel and the counsel for the planning zoning board through that pump, right? Give them all the information.
To a minor extent. I was providing information as needed, which is what I do with outside counsel.
That's true. I understand that. But I'm just saying that you were, I always thought you were pretty busy.
Maybe, that's true.
Maybe I was under the wrong impression all these years that you appeared to be working your butt off and you weren't.
Actually, if you count the hours, it's been that way since day one. Hampton is a unique community with unique challenges, and I've never wanted for busyness.
So I'm just really concerned about this change. I'm just trying to say with that, not trying to get into whether you work hard or not. That's another issue all by itself. But back to this, I'm really quite concerned with this move, very concerned. So that's all I really have to say.
Actually, I would like to say that I think the selectmen have thought this through pretty well. Just as the case with Wanda, where we saw that there was an ability and a desire to do the type of work that she did, you've got the same with the assistant town manager. And I think with his access to outside counsel as well in this labor area, and with his experience, I think the town will be very well served.
Thank you for bringing that up. That reminds me of something else I really wanted to ask. I know that when I was a selectman, we had a situation where there was a, I don't know how to say this carefully.
Michael, I just want to caution that I know a couple of you have been selectmen. Just don't go into any old cases in any
I'm not going to give, thank you, Madam Chair, for giving me the warning. But if there is a town employee, disregarding my experience, a town employee who has some kind of a situation where they're being harassed by a superior, like a general, and it happens to be female.
Mike, what does that have to do with the budget?
I'm getting back to that, Madam Chairman, if you'll let me finish. That's a second interruption. Thank you. Anyway.
No, it's a point of honor.
Back to the question. If we have this person rather than a Wanda, do you think a female would have a problem with dealing with that?
Michael, do you have a question on a number?
Say again?
You have a question on a number.
Yes, I do.
Not an issue.
That has to do with transferring the money back and forth on people.
If you don't have a person that can deal
with the job, we can't make the transfer with the money. It all goes hand in hand.
Well, that's just a qualification question. I don't think you need to go into any sort of a scenario.
Well, that's your opinion, but I think that's a legitimate question. Do you care to answer that, Mark?
Our personnel policies have people to whom reports are made, the initial reports. And in the past, the people to whom reports could be made included my office and the finance director.
Okay.
And so now you have a person who's the finance director of a different sex, and you have me, so I think we're covered. Okay. If that's the concern.
Yeah, that was my concern. Thank you, Mark. I'm all set.
Thank you, Mark. Nice to see you again.
Yes, indeed. Thank you.
The question I was going to ask had to do with what Mr. Pierce just asked, so I won't belittle that. I was a little concerned about the 50 going to 59 so quickly, but I think that's already been addressed. As far as the new planner, 15 minutes ago I met with Jason on another matter that if he wasn't in existence, I would have had him thrown you. So there's an example of somebody where it can be delegated. He was very responsive, and I'm going to meet with him tomorrow. So that's true. And for a town employee to say that they can handle the workload, I take my hat off to you for it. So I'm not going to argue with you that you don't have enough to do. So,
well, to the extent that it does get to be too much, I'm convinced the Board of Selectmen would endorse my using the outside council budget more than I have in the past, and the amount that's in there I think is sufficient to cover that.
Thank you, Mark. That's all I have, Mr. Chairman.
Jerry, I'm going to pass to you and go to Brian.
Maybe this is more of a twist to you, but on page 20.
Page 20?
That
would be
that's outside of
my expertise.
Sorry.
What page do you want, Brian?
I want 24.
24. Okay.
Just something that just might need to be cleared up. I'm just being picky, but this line item funds the wages of the town attorney and assistant town attorney. I don't believe there is an assistant town attorney.
When the original budget was made, there was, though, and this right page always reflects what was originally requested. So next year it will change and it will come out. But for this year, we don't usually Mike has never changed the right side page during the process of the budget.
Okay, it just gets a little confusing because you're supposedly paying two people or not.
The comment, though, is remember when the department head submitted it, that's how the comments come over. Situation changed from that point. It was then reviewed by the manager and then the board of selectmen. And that circumstance changed during that period of time. That's all.
Thank you.
Attorney Gerald, I find myself in a unique position here. I think the last time we talked about budget, I was probably on the other side, saying we didn't need a part-time anything, going back to a few rounds. But now I find myself, having listened to all the arguments in the past, wondering if we're going in the right direction, in this direction. I want to go back to last year. Last year there was a proposed position of somebody for filing and scanning because you had been overwhelmed. And you're telling me that this year you were given that person to do the scanning and do the filing.
Clerical work of all
clerical kinds. I remember asking, is this person paralegal that you will be hiring? It was strictly clerical, basically along the lines of a file clerk. And now we have that position that was added to the budget. I'm not sure where the money came from to pay for that position this year. Have you had it since March?
Yes. Okay. First, it was asked of me whether or not I thought the addition of that person would cause the budget to amount for the year to be exceeded. And I felt it would not.
But since you had budgeted previously and it was a default budget, which is hypothetically bare bones to begin with, and you were in the beginning of the of only one quarter into the year?
Well, actually, when you... every month, like all department heads, I get a running look at how things are being expended, mm-hmm. and I also can keep in mind what is the caseload that I've got, and I monitor that. How much do I do in-house? How much is referred to outside counsel? So I have an idea as I go along, and it varies at any given moment how much is needed. So at that point, I was able to forecast. Yes, I can build that person in and will not likely exceed the budget.
And now that person that was built in the same year it was built in, that position is now being expanded.
By four hours at $16 an hour.
Up is up. it inches up that way, and then before you know it, we have a full-timer. So the idea is coverage, and...
Well, that's not what I'm proposing here. It's not what the selectmen have approved. The selectmen are very vigilant about adding positions that have benefits associated with them, and as you see, the assistant town manager position is just such a position, part-time.
Now, is that a flat $16 rate, or is it $16 and change?
Flat rate.
Flat $16 a month.
Yeah.
I almost get the feeling like we're sacrificing this year. And based on past history and how much your department has done, I'm not sure we won't be here next year talking about another part-time attorney.
Well, Wanda Brott was full-time as assistant town attorney and human resources coordinator. And the important thing about that was it was in-house capacity, not outside capacity. And that's what is being replaced. It's in-house capacity for in-house capacity.
Well, with Wanda, we had an attorney that was home-groomed. We supported her through school.
Yes, and actually, as I had charted it out, the investment paid off plus.
Mm-hmm. Now we're back to the beginning, plus 20 hours for a part-time person.
But at $16 an hour, rather than her total, which was 44 an hour for everything.
Wanda had a beginning, too, and my mm-hmm. concern is that this is a position that the voters did not get an opportunity to vote for the way it was done.
Well, actually, the selectmen make the policy decision and implement how departments are organized. The voters don't generally get the creation of positions. They get the approval of the budget amounts for them.
However, I think overwhelmingly, the creation of these new positions across the board, and not just with you, we're seeing it in every department, is impacting our tax bill further down the road, higher and higher and higher, and the voters seem to be at arm's length. So I know you can't give me a crystal ball on what's going to happen. I know you had a glut of cases, and when you came on board, I can understand where you had probably more than you should have had for all the things that were just waiting for you to come on board. And now things seem to have settled down a little bit. Certainly the planner is a good example of what slid on your plate and now is off your plate again, which is a very good thing. But that's not to say that as the new planner gets entrenched in what's going on, that it doesn't shift the other way to have you help straighten things out again. And I just am trying to look to see where we're going down the road. Are there any plans to educate this part-timer?
Not in that same way. You know, you deal with the personnel you have, and hopefully you have capacity to accomplish a lot, and we do. We're very lucky to have the person who's got an MBA, who's sitting in the assistant town manager position, who can handle a lot that Wanda was handling, and in a preventative way. That's the advantage of in-house, really. And whether that person is in-house with the title of human resources coordinator and assistant town attorney or assistant town manager, we have that in-house capacity, and I would hope the voters can appreciate that the selectmen have done the comprehensive analysis that was needed to know how is the best way to handle this with the people we have. Mm-hmm. And I think if the load changes and the emphasis needs to points in the direction of having a part-time assistant town attorney, I would be confident that the selectmen would support such a thing.
Okay. And one last question. All this scanning and archiving that this part-timer was hired for originally, who is doing that now? Or is that now put aside?
My desk is a lot cleaner than it was, that's for sure. It wasn't, things that of a clerical nature, of a filing nature, were not getting done nearly as well as they are now. I'm fortunate that I don't have to answer every ring of the phone. It's a major benefit. And as I say, that person is not simply filing. She has the experience to adapt documents that we've already created. To accomplish in a given case what's needed, of course, with supervision.
Okay, thank you.
Change is difficult sometimes.
Sure is.
And this is going to be quite a change. I think 6 months to a year from now, we'll have a better idea of how this is going to work. The selectmen have chosen to make the change, and I think we probably should support it for a year to see if it does pan out. There was a lot of discussion about Wanda's position in the beginning, pros and cons, and as it went to fruition, it proved to work fairly well.
Yes, so it did.
I think to do anything to this year is short-sighted. I think it should should stay the way it is, see how it works.
I think if you were going to replace someone with human resources coordinator and assistant town attorney for the price, whether it be $50,000 or $59,000, would be awfully difficult.
So I think we ought to support this. Have to have you come in. A couple weeks ago, it was a little bit kind of a toss-up, but having your explanation and hearing the thought that went through to get to this, I feel better tonight than I did a couple weeks ago. I'd support it.
Mark, I want you to look me in the eye, raise your right hand, and swear to tell the truth. Okay? And I can do this because I'm a justice of the peace. If you're telling me that this is going to work, if you're comfortable with it, it's your department, it's your job,
then I have to go with it.
Okay. I think there's enough built in for contingency, as there always has been, with the outside council amount and the flexibility that the selectmen, I think, would give me if that need becomes so much that it makes sense to hire someone in-house at a much lesser cost than the out-of-house was costing, I'm comfortable with it too.
I have the same concerns that everybody here has, but it's your department. You've got to make it work. And if this is what you're comfortable with, then how can I object?
I'm looking forward to the type of expertise that Jamie can bring. We're going to try some different approaches in areas such as collective bargaining that don't use outside counsel as much, and we'll see how it goes.
And I know that you work as a team.
Yes, we do.
With the new town planner, with Christy, with everybody. Everybody works as a team, so they're all working together. So,
sure.
Very good. Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Jim? No question.
Hi, Mark. Just one question.
Sure.
Over on page 26, the top line.
Yes.
You've only budgeted $1 for a technical reason for keeping damages and judgments at $1.
Sure.
Other than which, on the face of it, says that your batting average is really, really, really good. And I know the outside of the Nextera case, which was just recently settled, can you tell us how much has been covered by insurance or reserved fund balance? Any cases? Or are you that good?
Well, this damages and judgments does not pertain to the tax abatement area.
Oh,
that's
okay.
Covered by a different line.
Okay.
It does not cover such things as employment separation costs.
Okay.
This has only been used a couple of times in the 12 years I've been here, which were cases that I inherited. It definitely makes a big difference to have in-house personnel working at things from the ground up, because you can head a lot of things off.
Oh, sure.
And I'm looking forward to that happening in the labor area with the assistant manager as well.
Thank you.
Thank you.
Hello, Mark.
Hello.
You know, a couple weeks ago, when we were talking about the general government and we were looking at the town manager's budget, we tabled it because there was concerns about what was happening between the movement of responsibilities from your office over to the town manager.
Sure.
And also the changes of the monies in those things. And I've been trying to resolve that to satisfy my own way of doing things here. When I'm looking at page 23.
Sure.
When I look at the 2014 budget on regular wages, it's $144,035. Right? The 2015 recommended budget is $103,258. So I assume that the difference, now we're talking just salary, right?
Right.
So that difference is basically was Wanda's salary, wasn't it?
No. This line, as from the manager, coming from the manager, actually builds in a raise for me, as it does in several other departments.
With the 103?
Yes.
103,000?
That includes a raise for...
But when I took those two figures, I take the 144,035.
Sure.
And I subtract the 103,258, I come up with 40,777.
Yep, I'll have to defer to Christy to answer that one.
Well, Christy?
When you subtract what I saw, 156,326?
No, 144,035 was the 2014 budget. Mm-hmm. The 2015 budget is 103,258, right?
Mm-hmm.
The difference is 40,777.
Yes.
Now, looking at that in bare bones, I would have to assume that was Wanda's salary.
No.
Because it's been reduced.
No.
Mm-mm. No.
Never mind all of the benefits and anything, just the basic salary.
I just looked at my work papers, yeah. So I can answer for you that her salary was, what did I tell you, $50,772 based on her hourly rate that I had in my work papers.
$50,000 give or take, right?
$50,772.
$50,772.
So the difference you're looking for is your raise, right? Mr. Gerald?
I think so. I think that's what...
It seems that that's the raise.
That would be about what I...
Right.
Because it was a 9%.
No, on top of that, $50,772 mm-hmm. were the benefits that she was entitled to. The health insurance, life insurance, workman's comp, retirement, Social Security, Medicare. And you did read off... Right? Now, that money's come from another pool.
Different lines.
A different line item because it encompasses all town employees.
Yeah.
Sure. Right? So now... So we have $50,772 as was the salary for the second employee in legal. Now we have a proposal for an assistant town attorney and HR coordinator with a salary of $59,493. I guess.
That was proposed. That no longer.
Well, I'm looking at the sheet that was given us.
That was going to be proposed.
All right, so what is it?
$50,772 is what she just said.
That sheet's going to be corrected.
Now that sheet's
just sort of clear on that.
Yeah.
Those were the numbers that Fred was working on as the proposed from the budget. Since then, as was pointed out here, her current salary at the time she passed away is that
$50,772. Yeah, I just checked my
hourly rate. So adding all of the other benefits in the position of town attorney HR coordinator, what's the bottom, the money's come from other
84,768.
At the
bottom line. Right. I had it up to fringe.
I was going to redo that sheet. I made myself a note because Eileen had asked. Someone had asked when we were going around, and I will be redistributing that sheet.
Oh, all right. Well, again, I'm looking at just what I have in front of me right now. Because
that was based on what was in the budget.
Yeah. All right.
When that was prepared, it was based on what was in the 2015 budget, which had the increase in it.
Proposed budget.
I guess my last question is, looking at the correlation between these,
if it could have been,
the position. Can you give me a brief job description of human resources? What does the human resources person do?
I guess that really should come out of Fred's office, right? It's not necessarily a question for Mark.
Oh, well.
That to Fred and give you the answer for that. Our office can give you the description.
Well, you're the new HR coordinator.
Right.
Can you very briefly give me your job description? Yeah, very briefly.
You're responsible for the town's HR stuff.
I mean, well, that's HR. What the hell is HR?
Thank you.
Off
topic
anyway.
Job description.
Right.
Something that Fred has been working on prior to his leaving. So that's this all happened quickly, and he's putting that together. But I will be responsible for developing my initial directions when I get into that position, Fred returns, will be to develop you know, policies, procedures, deal with issues. There are a number of things that have to be streamlined, that need to be coordinated, some that have been highlighted recently that we need to fix. And those will be my responsibility to work on. In addition to other duties assigned.
You can see what my question is, Roy. Just the correlation between
so bottom line right here, now, currently, we do not have a printed job description. It's in the works.
Yeah, to my knowledge, it's in the works. You know, again, with Fred was out for his issues. My issues, I've got directives of what I'm doing. Currently, I'm doing Fred's job. And when I come back, I suspect that's something we'll be working on.
But again, Mark, you're comfortable with the way this budget is?
You already said.
Yes. Yes. That's all.
All right.
Thank you.
Madam Chair, if I might. Given that we have new data coming from our finance director, thanks to Michael's question and Rich's question regarding the need for that new data, and given the nature of the attorneys, or excuse me, the legal item being intertwined with the town manager's item, and we have previously tabled the town manager's item, I think it's appropriate that we table the legal and combine the discussion with the town manager at a subsequent meeting. So I would so move that we table the motion on legal until we have a meeting with the town manager line item at a subsequent meeting. I get a second.
Second.
Thank you.
I agree.
All those in favor?
Mike Pierce seconded it.
Mike Pierce seconded. And it doesn't have a good or a bad to it. I just think we need to embrace it all. And
that's fine.
I'm opposed.
Oh, I'm sorry.
I'm opposed.
Opposed.
Keep your hands up if you're opposed.
Who's opposed? I'm opposed. You're opposed too? Mm-hmm. I'm on the boat right now.
The two rebels.
No, no, I can understand.
I'm just teasing.
Jim's really heard this before, and
no, only Jerry and who is opposed?
And
Jim.
Jerry and Mr. Waddell.
And they're opposed to tabling.
Okay. I'm opposed to tabling. Yeah.
I can't sit out of my pocket.
Well, you've tabled it.
All right.
Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Thanks for having me first.
Yeah. I could make one more suggestion, one more comment. Wanda passed the bar in both Mass and New Hampshire. She was a great person.
Indeed.
Looking at what you've added in for outside hours for legal expenses on page 25, at $200 an hour, I feel you added in 150 hours. This tells me you're going to be 1,500 hours short, which could be $300,000 if it's all outside at $200 an hour. I took Wanda's total 40 hours times 52, subtracted vacation, holiday, sick time, and HR time, came up with 1,654, subtracted the hours you've got in here for outside council fees and other labor costs, which is about 150 hours at the rate of $200 an hour. So I'm saying you're short 1,504 hours. If you went outside to buy that, that's $300K. I was ready to vote.
But you also reduced for what her workload was.
Okay. We've gone around the table.
Well, since we tabled it, I mean, Jerry will have, and the rest of us will have an opportunity to send written questions again.
Yes.
And they will be distributed, and he'll be better prepared to answer those questions. That's kind of a detailed question for him to answer. And I think,
so
we'll give him a chance when you send out your new
still,
set of questions.
It's still an open discussion.
Mm-hmm. Yeah.
Mm-hmm. About town managers. Mm-hmm.
Just wanted to point that out, that's all. Yeah.
It's not a yay or nay either way. There's no negativity based with it. Just we're still inputting some information here, and we're not ready to deal with it tonight, but we will be ready.
Sure.
At some point in time. Thank you very much.
Thank you very much.
Thank you.
Thank you, Mark.
Thank you.